The parliamentary conference hall has been a theatre of scandals for over 2 weeks now, with the inquiry into mismanagement of savers' money at the National Social Security Fund exposing abuse. The committee again interfaced with the ex-NSSF managing director, Richard Biarugaba, who was accused by the NSSF Board of Engineering a 1.8 billion shilling budget disguised as corporate social responsibility. It is said the money later was shared among the top management, including board members, Gender Minister Betty Amongi, and two trade unions. When squeezed further, Biarugaba instead threw the ball to the chief financial officer, Stephen Mwanje, claiming he was behind the breakdown of the budget and sent him details through a WhatsApp message. This forced the committee to confiscate the two phones and handed them over to the CID department at Parliament to follow up.
To you through an email, through a message, through a message. And can you prove that to this committee? Yeah. It's here. Share with the chairperson. Director of Finance, don't delete any chat, please.
CID, can you kindly retrieve that phone?
Don't.
Are you called Stevens? On 4th of May 2022 at 12:10 p.m. you sent this slide to this mobile phone.
Sir Chairman, I have no recollection at all.
So, the origin. Why spend savers' money on corporate social investment? Let's say if we use this figure, you send 2.3 billion donations that are not going to have accountability by them. Someone wakes up and gives whoever he wants, and there's no accountability for this money. So, we want to establish the source.
The Mwine Mpaka-led committee also interfaced with NSSF management again on the controversial procurement of 2.6 billion shilling fake smart card technology, which failed to work.
A team, a verification team, traveled to India to validate the functionality. This is very key. The functionality, and you came back and gave a report of its functionality that led to the procurement of this card. We later on even invested more money to get a project team to go around the country and issue out these cards. In the end, it came to our knowledge that the card only had a person's name and his NSSF number.
It was discovered that the head of procurement, Gerald Mugabe, who led the NSSF team to India for due diligence and verified its functionality, had no technical knowledge on the technology which was procured on savers' cash and failed to work.
There were two IT experts. There was Solomon Muganwa, who I think who has left now, who was the project manager, and Benon commented about it, and also Simon Kule, who is in office, right?
Simple thing, the functionality of the card, you cannot tell. That needs IT person. I don't know on your contingency if there was an IT person. Second, we are saying you went to verify the technology. How do you verify the technology?
The probe committee also discovered that fund managers have been irregularly dishing out savers' money to private companies. For example, 2.3 billion shillings was casually sunk into the project of Arua Golf Club Hotel, but it is not reflected anywhere in books of NSSF.
Billion in constructions related to a golf course, I think, in Arua, and we lost that money. Can you kindly brief us?
Where we find on the files of the fund that there is a legacy investment made, it is still our responsibility to try and recoup that investment.
A casual arrangement. I think so. That means there was no board resolution, no whatever, no means, no commitments.
Committee members pinned department heads at NSSF of using their influence to recruit their relatives for positions under their supervision. For example, Geoffrey Sajabi, the chief commercial officer, admitted to having five relatives in his department, but defended their recruitment.
Staff is called Nevia Nangobi.
Yes.
She's your sister.
That's not true.
Another staff is called Joel Muganza.
Yes.
Is your brother-in-law.
That's true.
Another staff is called Rashid Waiswa.
Yes.
Is your cousin.
That's not true.
Another staff is called Amanda Acheng.
Yes.
Is your niece.
That's true.
Defended their
recruitment. Another staff is called...
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.
He's your nephew.
That's true.